Good day, sir. Good day, classmate. I'm midshipman Custodio from NS1A4. So I'm gonna illustrate how to navigate in the traffic separation scheme. So a vessel using a traffic separation scheme shall proceed in the proper traffic lane in the general direction of a traffic flow for that lane. So we can see now, these two vessels are following the traffic separation scheme. They are in the appropriate line, following the general direction of flow as indicated by the arrow so far. As a practicable, keep clear of a traffic separation lane or separation zone. Separation line and separation zone are the magenta areas on the chart. Clearly, the bit between the lanes in the separation zone in the bits of the edges are the separation lines normally. Join or leave a traffic lane at the termination of the lane, but when joining or leaving from either side, shall do so at small angle to the general direction of a traffic flow as practicable. So the blue vessel is coming out to leave the small angles and is safe practicable. She's going to a port along the side of a traffic separation scheme. And the green vessel has left at the termination of the lane. A vessel shall so far are practicable avoid crossing traffic lane, but is obliged to do so, shall cross in a heading as nearly as practicable at right angles to the general direction of a traffic flow. So now, the red vessel wants to cross the traffic lanes. They got to maintain a heading at the right angles to the direction of flow in each of the lanes. They've got to straight across as quick as they can. But what happens if their vessel sideways? Will they still go to maintain that heading at right angles? Yes, they're going to be swift sideways in the ground traffic's the white angles, but the heading must be. You can see that traffic follows. It's actually quite a long one, but they maintain their right angle heading. The reason for this is you need to maintain aspect and get cross the lane as quick as you can.
Hello sir, good day. I am midshipman Guzman Arcie, NS1A4. Our topic for today is illustrate how to proceed in the entrance of appropriate traffic lane. It is an area with defined limits in which one-way traffic is established. Natural obstacles, including those forming separation zones, may constitute a boundary, also narrows used to indicate the direction of traffic flow. This is the example of how practicable keep clear of a traffic separation lane or separation zone. Normally, join or leave a traffic lane at the termination of the lane, but when joining or leaving from either side, shall do so at a smaller angle to general direction of traffic flow. As practicable, a vessel shall so far as practicable avoid crossing traffic lanes, but if obliged to do so shall cross on a heading as nearly as practicable at the right angles to the general direction of traffic flow.
Hey everyone, I'm midship Imam Jabber M from BSMT S1A4. This is my video presentation about illustrate how to live in the traffic lane to cross on the separate lane or zone. 1. A vessel using a traffic separation shall letter A, proceed in the proceed traffic lane in the general direction of traffic flow for the lane. Letter B, so far as practicable, keep clear of the traffic separation lane or separation zone. Letter C, normally join or leaving a traffic lane at the termination of the lane, but when joining or leaving from either side, shall do so as a small an angle to the general direction of the traffic flow as practicable. Rule 10 state the ship crossing traffic lanes are required to do as nearly as practicable at right angle to the general direction of traffic flow. This reduced confusing to other ships as to the crossing vessels' intention and course, and the same time enables that vessel to the crossing the lane of quickly as possible.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, mates. So this is Midshipwoman Dela Peña reporting about the illustrate how to cross on the opposite traffic lane to proceed to inshore traffic. This rule applies to traffic separation scheme adopted by organization and does not relieve any vessel to her obligation under my other rules. So, a vessel using a traffic separation scheme shall proceed in appropriate traffic lane in general direction of traffic flow for that lane. Okay. So far as practicable, keep clear of the traffic separation line or separation zone. Normally, join or leave a traffic lane at the termination of the lane, but when joining or leaving from either side, shall do so at the small and angle to the general direction to the traffic flow as practicable. A vessel shall, so far as practicable, avoid crossing traffic lanes but not obligated to do, shall cross on heading as nearly as the practicable of the right angle and general direction of the traffic flow. So I will show you some picture. Crossing ATS shall ensure she heads at the 90 degree to the lane indoor to show a beam aspect. So, okay. A vessel shall not use an inshore traffic zone when she can safely use the appropriate traffic lane within the adjacent traffic separation scheme. However, of less than 20 meters in length, sailing traffic and vessel engaged in fishing may use to ensure the traffic zone scheme traffic zone. So, notwithstanding subparagraph, a vessel may use inshore traffic zone when a route to the front of the port, offshore installation or sick structure, pilot station, any other place situated within the inshore traffic zone. So that's the example of how to cross on the opposite traffic lane to proceed to inshore traffic zone.
Hello sir and hello mates. I'm Midshipman Jason Partosa, NS1A4, and I illustrate the use of inshore traffic zone to reach destination. Inshore traffic zone means routing measure comprising a designated area between the landward boundary of a traffic separation scheme and the adjacent coast to be used in accordance with the provisions of Rule 10. As amended of the International Regulation for Preventing Collision at Sea 1972 Coal Regs. A traffic separation SHIMS or TSS is a maritime traffic management route system ruled by International Maritime Organization or IMO. The traffic lanes or clearly indicate the general direction of the ships that zone. Ships navigating within a TSS all sail in the same direction or day across. The lane is in angle as close to 90 degree as possible. TSS are used to regulate the traffic at BC, confined waterway or around capes. Within a TSS or a traffic separation schemes, there is normally at least one traffic lane in each main direction. turning points, deep water lanes, and separation zone between the main traffic lanes. Most TSS, or the traffic separation zones, includes inshore traffic zone between the traffic lanes and the cause. The inshore traffic zone is unregulated and is not intended to be used for true traffic, but rather for local traffic, fishing, and small craft. A ship navigating is a traffic lane should sail in the general direction of that lane. The body of water between two opposite lanes is to be avoided by vessel traveling, such as emergencies or for fishing activities. Where needed, there are special zones where a lane splits into two channels, one ongoing and the other to the nearby ports. The TSS, or the traffic separation schemes, rules are incorporated in the international regulations for preventing collision at sea. Under Part B, Section 1, Rule 10, Traffic Separation Schemes, an individual TSS is controlled by a vessel traffic service. That's all, sir. Thank you.